Hey there, Vanderbilly. Someone requested this, so I'll see what I can do. Goes like this. Play it through, and then I'll give you some instruction on it. Back on the chain gang. Intro starts out on the B and G strings at the 10th and 11th fret. Okay, then you're going to slide it down to the 5th and 6th fret, and then the 3rd and the 4th fret. Okay? And you'll have to listen to the rhythm. It actually starts, I think, on like the 2, not the 1, the first time through, and then it's an even kind of a 4-4 on each one. After that, the chords are pretty simple. It's a D without your middle finger down. It's just the two fingers on the G and the B string. D, A, E minor. Now, instead of playing the normal E minor there, I play it with these two fingers because the next two chords are B minor and G, but I rarely play them when I'm playing the song with the band. What I do is I go from this E minor that I put down, make it an E minor 7th, and then put down my pinky, which I'm not exactly sure what chord that is, but basically it turns it from the kind of the B minor to the G without having to play the whole chord. So it goes, okay, playing both of those. Does that through I think 4 times. Then you get to the chorus, and the chorus is just E minor and A. And then the first time through, it goes to the D, and then goes to the A, and then goes back to the D. Okay? It does that for a second verse. In the second verse, instead of going D and A, it goes back into the... there's the lead going on at the same time. After the lead, it comes out in the D. And then the bridge comes in. The bridge is D minor. And A7th. And that's it. And that's the powers that be and all that stuff. That's just the bridge. Occasionally, he does a D minor and pulls off on... there's just a little pull off on the E string for the D minor and then the A. So it's a D minor and an A7th. And then at the end of the bridge, it holds the A for a little longer. And then goes in, it modulates up a key to, and so it goes to the E. B. So after the bridge, what happens is it holds that A for a little while, then it goes E, B, A, B. And then the back on the chain gang is just A, B, back on the chain. And then then when they go in, after that, the chorus, they just do E and B, and it's just arpeggiated. And that's how the song ends. Okay? The leads. Is starting on the 7th fret on the D string, D twice, and then G, B, and then the B on the 10th fret, and then twice there, 8th fret, 7th fret, 5th fret, and then bend on the 3rd, and back to the 2nd, and back to the 3rd. Okay, and it does that twice. All right. Okay. The other thing it does. It's a little octave thing, starting on the 11th fret on the G string and the 14th fret on the E string. Then move it up one, and then move it up two. So it's 11, 12, and 14. And you'll hear that if you listen to the CD. Steps up a key to E, they start, instead of starting there, they move up two, and then they do it. Okay? And it's hard to do both of these at the same time. You'll actually have to listen to it. Okay? It's this little run. Is it's the G on the 3rd fret, hit the B and the E string together, then the 2nd fret on the E string, then open, then the B and G string on the 3rd and 4th fret, to the 2nd fret B and G string. So it goes. And that's the riff. And when it's moved up to the E, when they modulate up a step, okay, so you're going on the E and the B strings again on the 5th fret this time. And then the second and fourth frets, and then to the B string. Okay, and then basically you're hitting the B and the G strings, and you're just kind of covering up from the second and fourth fret. And these will make much more sense. It's hard to play them at the same time because I can't. You know, that's where that comes in. And it comes. So there you go. That's kind of all of it put together. That should get you through the whole song.